Hello guys, in this video we will discuss about the SN1 reaction, which is the substitution nucleophilic and unimolecular reaction. So an example, we have to consider an example of SN1 reaction. Here is a typical example of SN1 reaction, which is a tertiary bromide which upon solvolysis in aqueous medium produces the two enantiomers. We have started from the optically pure S isomer and we have obtained both the R and the S isomer in 1:1 ratio. So this is a typical SN1 reaction. The rate of the SN1 reaction is dependent on the concentration of the halide, that is the substrate molecule. So what is the mechanism of SN1 reaction? So initially, in the first step, the carbon bromine bond or the carbon halide bond, halogen bond, will break in order to produce the corresponding carbocation. So formation of this carbocation is very slow, since a stable molecule is producing a very unstable intermediate. That's why its activation energy for this step will be very high. For that reason, this step is very much slow, and that's why it is a rate determining step. So after the formation of this carbocation, since carbocation is a planar entity which has a which is sp2 hybridized, the central carbon is sp2 hybridized and it has a vacant p orbital. So the entering nucleophile, in this case the nucleophile is water molecule. So water molecule can attack from either from the top face or from the bottom face to produce the S and R product respectively. If it attacks from the top face, then this S enantiomer will form, and if the water molecule attacks from the bottom face, then the R enantiomer will form. Let us consider the energy profile diagram for this reaction. Since it is a two-step process, thus there will be an intermediate which is the carbocation, and it will have two transition state. This is the transition state number 1 and this is the transition state number 2. So the first step is the rate determining step. That's why the activation energy for this step will be highest. So initially the carbocation will form, and then this carbocation will, since it is a very highly energetically unstable species, so it will react immediately with the water molecule present in the reaction medium to produce the corresponding R and S enantiomers, and that's why the activation energy for the second step will be very low. So let us consider it again. Since in the first step, a stable molecule, which is the halide, is converted into the unstable species, which is the carbocation. That's why the activation energy for the first step will be high. And since the unstable species, the carbocation, is converted into the stable product molecule, that's why its reactivity, since the reactivity of carbocation is very high, that's why the activation energy for the second step will be very low. So this is the transition state for the rate determining step. And this is the overall energy profile diagram. Okay, so now we will consider the factors which affect the rate of the SN1 reaction. So first and foremost, it is the structure of the substrate. So if you consider these three halides, so as we go from the top to bottom, the stability of the resulting carbocation from these halides is in the decreasing order. If this bond breaks, then it will form a tertiary butyl cation, which is highly stable due to the plus I and hyperconjugation effect of 3 methyl groups. In the next molecule, the hyperconjugable hydrogen atom number is decreasing. In the third molecule, it is again further decreasing, and ultimately in the methyl halide, there is no hyperconjugable hydrogen atom. So thus, since the formation of the carbocation is the most important thing in case of SN1 reaction, thus as you go from top to bottom, the probability for SN1 mechanism is also decreasing. So in this case, it will be 100% SN1, and as you go downwards, the probability of SN1 will decrease. So let us consider the second factor is the solvent. Okay, first we have to draw the energy profile diagram again. So this is a typical energy profile diagram of a SN1 reaction. This suggests the carbocation intermediate. Since the starting material is neutral, the intermediate is a carbocation which is polar, contains a positive charge, and the product molecule is also neutral. So if we increase the polarity of the solvent medium, then the stabilization of this polar intermediate of this carbocation will be much more prominent than the starting material and the product. That is, changing the solvent from non-polar to polar will decrease the energy from here to here of the carbocation species, but the energy of the substrate and the product molecule will remain more or less same. So after changing the solvent, if we draw the energy profile diagram again, so now we can see that there is a overall stabilization or overall lowering of the activation energy is occurring when the solvent is changing from non-polar to polar. In the same way, if the solvent is protic, then since protic solvent contains the hydrogen donor molecules like water and alcohol molecules, so they are polar as well as protic. So here the stabilization will be much more pronounced. So the ultimate choice of solvent for SN1 reaction is thus polar and protic. Okay, so polar protic solvent will be the most effective for SN1 reaction. Okay, now we have to consider the third factor, which is the entering group. Suppose the reaction is carried out in presence of this nucleophiles. So this is the methoxide anion, this is acetate anion, this is OH minus hydroxide anion, and this is bicarbonate anion. So these are the four conditions, and each anion is present as the nucleophile in four different conditions. So when will be the reaction much more faster in case of SN1? So as we know, in case of SN1, the rate is dependent only on the concentration of the substrate molecule. There is no effect on changing the living group, changing the nucleophile concentration, since the rate is entirely dependent on the concentration of the substrate. Thus, changing the strength of the nucleophile or entering group will not affect the rate of the SN1 reaction, but this will have a much more prominence effect in case of SN2 reaction, which we will discuss in the separate video. So now we will consider the fourth factor, which is the leaving group. So suppose we have four different halides, X equals to fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine. So the first step is the dissociation of this carbon halogen bond, formation of this carbocation, and the second step, the nucleophile will attack this carbocation and will produce this molecule. So this is the overall mechanism of the SN1 reaction. Since the first step is the rate determining step and the slowest step, so this step will be faster, comparatively faster, when there is a better leaving group. In the first step, the carbon halogen bond breaking is involved. So the carbon iodine bond will break in the fastest rate, then the carbon bromine, then the carbon chlorine, and then the carbon fluorine. This bond will break in the much this bond breaking is much more likely than carbon bromine, then carbon chlorine, then carbon fluorine, since the stability of I minus is greater than Br minus, than Cl minus, than F minus, which is also reflected in their acidity. Hi is most acidic, then HBr, then HCl, then HF. So I minus, removing I minus is much more feasible than removing Br minus, Cl minus, F minus. So the overall rate will be increased in case of Ri. Ri will be of highest rate, then RBr, then RCl, then RF. So this is the effect of the leaving group. Likewise, there are many other leaving groups which we will discuss in the separate video, where we will discuss each factors, the solvent effect, the structural effect, the leaving group effect, and the entering group effect, or the nucleophile effect. So this is it. This is the basic mechanism of SN1 reaction. I hope you guys like this video and have obtained some basic fundamental information about SN1 reaction. If you have any queries, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you for watching this video. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel. It will help me a lot. Once again, thank you.